Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Ramusha TV. The topic for today is the Turkish government scholarship. The selection procedure and results have been announced for the first round. So, as we all know, that the application was done on January up to the end of February, and the preliminary assessment has been done, whereby the applicants have been reviewed based on the criteria, which are the basics, such as minimum academic grades, age limit, required document, and stuff like that. So from there, some of us, we got the message saying that congratulating us for being selected for the further step, which is next step, stage two, whereby the second round, which will be done, and from there, some people who will win from there, we will get notified or shortlisted for the interview, and from there we have a high chance of winning. First of all, let me congratulate everyone among you who applied this scholarship this year. Actually, it started December, so you can say last year or this year, doesn't matter. So for most of us who we tried for our best to apply, let us congratulate ourselves. But for us who we were denied, I'm gonna read the message from the approval, like for people who have been sent that they have been congratulated to go for the next step. I'll read it here for you. So the message goes in this way. We would like to inform you that your application to Turkey Scholarship 2020 is considered to be eligible for the second round of evaluation. Applications of eligible candidates who were carefully examined by expert committee in the first evaluation round based on broad set of criteria, including academic standing, previous qualifications, academic interests, career goals, consistency of choices, clarity of letter of intent, participation in social activities, will be re-evaluated precisely in the second evaluation process. Results are displayed, stuff like that. So as we can see here, so the difference between the people who we were denied in this first round evaluation and those who were selected for further step, which is the second round, is based on these criteria, like letter of intent, the clarity of that, and the consistency in the goals, like the choices, mostly on the part, like maybe selecting the courses. You started a department from this side, but you are consistent into that, searching or choosing that department. Maybe you are a science student, but science-based students, sometimes you choose medicine, you fix, you are in business, you fix overwear and stuff like that. So it confuses them. You don't have consistency into your choices. So other criteria like academic outstandings and stuff like that, participation in social activities too matters. And most of us, we do ignore these activities mostly. We don't take much consideration in that. So we have seen here it has been among those ones. So let us congratulate ourselves first for those who we were selected, and for those who we are denied, we get the email like, we would like to inform you that due to stiff competition and stuff like that, your application was unsuccessful. But for people who will delay getting the notification from the Turkish government scholarship, you don't need to worry, because due to a bunch of students from all over the world, like more than how many millions people apply to this scholarship. So sometimes there is delaying traffic and sending or receiving the emails. So you need to keep calm and just wait. If you check on your inbox, spam and everywhere, like on your inbox, there's not any email from them. So you might be one among those who are your application are pending but not rejected. So you remain like a reserve. Sometimes you'll be selected, or if the reserve doesn't work out, you'll be rejected too, or you will miss the opportunity. So this was a bit I wanted to share. And for people now who were selected in this first round, you just need to keep calm, much prayers, as well as to just be following up regularly, check every time, like mostly as much as you can, be checking on your inboxes from different parts. You can check inbox, there's nothing, you check spam, different parts. So because sometimes message might come but not in your primary inbox. Yeah, but for normal, like the normal schedule, you know, due to COVID-19, the coronavirus has affected most of the procedures or activity or the schedule which were there, because it was arranged, they had arranged the schedule that from March to May here, like the interview would have been done. But now, like the selection, was it from May to June, and the interview would have been finished. And from June, July, August, the people who were selected from that. And from June, July, and August, the people who were selected from the interview and stuff like that, so will be going on with, you know, admission, you know, like after winning the scholarship is whereby they apply for you to the university. So those processes and the visas processes for people while waiting for their arrival here in Turkey around September. But right now, due to this COVID-19, you can see now currently we are in July and still in the first round. So the second round might delay a bit, but before the starting of the academic year, if no any changes, hopefully everything will be all right and everybody will be admitted or will be in his or her, like, particular university accepted. People who we didn't get this opportunity, if our dream was just to study here in Turkey, we might think of next year again to apply. So there is a lose of 1 year, or if still someone focuses on studying here in Turkey, someone might rethink of plan B, which will lead him or her into applying university scholarships. And university scholarship were a bit different application time compared to this government scholarship. So you can research over that. Different universities offer different kind of scholarships opportunities, from undergraduate, master's and degree, from partial to full tuition fee, depending on your academic excellence and stuff like that. Or you can apply for normal university as a private student, and also later on you can apply for grants from different institutions to sponsor you in your studies. So thank you so much, guys, for watching. If you're new here, my name is Ramadan from Ramosa TV, a medical student studying here in Turkey. See you. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new here. Bye bye.